I welcome everyone. Thank you for joining us today for Bethel Lighthouse Sunday broadcast. We give God thanks that we are still here all together, being able to just tell of the greatness of God for keeping us at such a time as this. So here we are. We are 6 months since March, since COVID, appeared, and since we've been in lockdown. Things are easing off a bit more, but you know, in the midst of all that, we've all encountered situations that are sorrowful, situations that have been of uncertainty, and things that we've had to adjust to. But you know, God is still in control. So right now, things are all easing back in, people have gone back into work, churches are reopening, and you know, we'll give you times and dates when we will reopen. And you know, people are also, children have gone back to school, so we need to cover them in prayer. But there's lots happening. So many new things, government guidelines, mask wearing, things about vaccines, you know, things that are so different to how they were before. But you know, in the midst of it, God is in control. God is in control. Yes, we have encountered a lot, and we do know that the enemy is at work. But you know, in Isaiah 59, verse 19, it says, when the enemy comes in like a flood, God will raise up a standard. The Spirit of the Lord will raise up a standard. So God is with us at all times, and we are surrounded, and He is able to do all that He can do to make sure that we are safe, secure, and we are winning. And you know, that's my topic. We know that with God we win. So I would just like to open up in prayer. Father God, we give you thanks and praise that, Lord, you have kept us, you are with us, you have gone before us, your angels surround us. There's so many things that's happening within our lives, but yet, Lord, we still trust you. We still believe in you, Lord God. And I pray for this broadcast that everybody will have an open heart and an open mind to receive the word, you know, join in with worship. But Lord, we pray most of all that everyone will be blessed. In your mighty name, Lord Jesus, we pray. Amen. So I'm going to pass over to Bethel Lighthouse praise team. And the first song we're going to sing is Arise, O God. And don't you think that that is so, so important? Don't you think that's an important topic? Arise, O God, in this time of uncertainty, in these times that we're in right now. So over to Warsaw Bethel Lighthouse praise team.
Here we are again with another song of praise unto the Lord our God. Arise, O God. And here is an opportunity, if you agree with us, to get up, give him praise, and let him know exactly how you feel.
Arise, O God.
Arise, O God.
And take your place. Let your kingdom be established.
Ancient of days.
You are good, and your mercy endureth forever.
May the Lord arise and stand up in your circumstance and in your
arise,
situation.
Arise, O God,
and take your place.
And take your place.
We enthrone you.
We enthrone you with our worship.
We come to give you praise. The song higher. Arise, O God.
Arise, O God.
Arise. rise and take your place.
Just take your place. We have come to give you glory.
Come to give you glory.
We have come to give you praise.
Why?
'Cause you are good.
'Cause he is good.
And your mercy endureth forever.
Let's take it higher. Let him know what we think all about him, because he is good. You are good. So good. Real good. And even from back then, he's still good
today. You are good.
As we already know, you are
you
good.
You are good. So good.
So good. So good. Yeah. You are good.
You are good. So good. Real good.
Everybody get up on your feet and let him know how good
you
he
are
is.
Good.
Praise team for that song. Arise, O God, our God, our mighty God. Isn't he just awesome? Let us magnify him and praise his name. We're now going to go into a second praise song. You know, your presence is heaven to me. Worship, that's what God wants. Worship. Let us keep in the vein of worship, keeping God at the pinnacle of who he is, because he is worthy of all our praise. Amen. Over to Bethel Lighthouse praise team. Be blessed.
Just love.
Amen. Hallelujah. Your presence is heaven to me. God, we just love you. We praise you. Thank you, praise team, for that song. And we're now going to go over to the scripture reading by Melinda Williams.
Greetings, brethren. I pray that everyone is staying safe. God bless you, and I pray that we get to see each other soon. Today's scripture reading is taken from 1 John chapter 2, verse 24-28, and I'm reading from the New King James Version. Therefore, let that abide in you which you heard from the beginning. If what you heard from the beginning abides in you, you will also abide in the Son and in the Father. And this is the promise that he has promised us, eternal life. These things I have written to you concerning those who try to deceive you, but the anointing which you have received from him abides in you, and you do not need that anyone teach you, but as the same anointing teaches you concerning all things and is true and is not a lie, and just as it has taught you, you will abide in him. And now, little children, abide in him. When he appears, we may have confidence and not be ashamed before him at his coming. I normally like to say, and now, little children, live in him, that when he appears, we may have confidence and not be ashamed before him at his coming. I always replace the word abide to live. Live in him, live in the Son, live in the Father, because I relate better with that word, and that's also one of the meanings of abide. And then we've got the next scripture reading, which is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 58. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. I'm just going to say it again. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. And what stuck out in the scripture to me is being steadfast, taking a firm, steady seat in this walk that we're doing with God. Immovable, that means when the storms of life come or whatever is thrown at us, we're not moved, we stay firm. And always abounding, always exceedingly doing the work of the Lord. So make sure we're always overdoing excessive work of the Lord, knowing that our labor is not in vain in the Lord. God bless you, and God bless his word, which is living and which is applicable today and forevermore. God bless you.
Thank you, Melinda, for the scripture reading. Amen. We'll now come to that time, the time for the word. I pray that you, your hearts are ready to receive. So now I'm going to hand over to our co-pastor, Elder David Copeland. I pray that this word will be enriching and a blessing to your lives.
Praise the Lord, everyone. I hope you're all doing well as viewers who are watching this broadcast today. And I hope you've already been blessed by what has gone forth. My name is David Copeland, Elder David Copeland, the Assistant Pastor of Lighthouse Christian Center. Normally you won't see me because I'm behind the scenes working on the music, working on the sound, but today I've been asked to bring the word. And the word in this day and in this age is so important. It is so important that regardless of what's going on around us, the word of God can still come forward to bring light, to bring peace, to bring power to the people of God. And we also pray that those who hear the word that may not believe us right now, the word comes also to change and to redirect and to bring purpose to those who before time have not known the Lord. So here we are today. And it goes without saying that we are living in perilous times. Even Jesus said over 2,000 years ago that perilous times will come. And as the time moves on and as things progress and advance, man thinks that we are doing great now because technology is at a certain place, finance is doing great, and everything is moving in a particular way that mankind tries to set it to be. But the Bible said, Jesus said, that perilous times will come. And no one needs to tell you or me that we're living in a time that really could be described as perilous. People are running around, not quite sure what's happening because of the pandemic situation that we're in at the moment. This thing has come and dropped right in the middle of our normality. It's come and dropped right in the middle of our lifestyle. It's disrupted the plans of many, many millions of people around the world because it has been such an unexpected situation. I look at this as chaos. Amen. Anything that comes along to disrupt plans and so-called organization, it's chaotic. And therefore, I would like to speak to you today on the subject, consistency in the chaos. Amen. You could be in your house, everything looks great in your house, in your household, your family, everything. But you know they're out there. We are surrounded by chaos because of the situation that we're in at the moment. What is chaos? I think I said before, it's the absence of order. It's the absence of direction. It's definitely the absence of normality. And to be honest, if you look into the heart of it, it's the absence of truth. Amen. Because what's happening now, men and women are looking to people who should have the answers at the top of their heads. And all they're doing is adding to the chaos. But the Bible says, especially when these situations come, I will look to the hills from whence my help comes. My help comes from who? From the Lord. And we must understand, people of God, that if we are called by the Lord, if we are called by our Maker, we have to continue to follow Him. Let's look at what the Word says. If you go to John, 1 John 2, and we look at even verse 24, first of all, it says, let that therefore abide in you which you have heard from the beginning. You know what you heard at the beginning. You know what came into your life to change you. I know what came into my life to change me, to cause me to be a firm believer in the word of the Lord. It went on to say, if that which ye have heard from the beginning shall remain in you, you shall also continue in the Son and in the Father. That's what I call consistency. Consistency means that you hold on, you keep things the same, you keep doing the same things consistently over a period of time. We do the things that have helped us. We do the things that have strengthened us because we believe in it. And when you believe in something, there's an old chorus that we used to sing, keep on believing, God will answer prayers. Because if God done it for you before, you can be sure He's going to do it for you again. Amen? Consistency breeds strength. Consistency strengthens your belief. And the main key to consistency is if we have purpose in our lives. When you have a purpose, that purpose draws you onto your destiny. That purpose draws you onto the place where you know God will be there to help you to do that which He has called you and me to do. Amen. The word even goes on to say, these things have I written unto you concerning them which seduce you. What does the word seduce mean? It means distraction using a very strong influence. A distraction that aims to pull you and to pull me, and it was trying to pull the people of God back in the Bible days away from their purpose. Now, when we are called into consistency, we can't be consistent today and next week we are not. We can't be consistent this month and next month we've given up. We've got to hold on to that which we heard in the beginning. Make it the keystone in your heart. Make it the main focus of your belief. Make it the main focus of your calling. Add it to your purpose, and it will help you and me to stay consistent. Let us even look at Jesus himself, the greatest teacher, the greatest leader that I know, the greatest leader that we all know. Even at the time and the approaching of chaos, Jesus said to his disciples, "They are coming to get me." And he said, "Some of you are going to fall away. Some of you are going to run." He said to Peter, "Peter, before the cockerel crows three times, you are going to deny me." Peter said, "Lord, that's not going to happen." How many times have we said, "Lord, tomorrow I'll be there. Lord, tomorrow I will stand for you." But when chaos comes, we are not where we promised that we would be. Peter, when chaos came, Peter drew a sword. Peter chopped off a man's ear, and then Peter ran. But who was consistent? The very person who they were going to kill. Jesus remained consistent because of his purpose, because of the job that he had to do, because of what stood before him. And yes, our consistency will be challenged. Jesus said, "Lord, if you could," that was the flesh of God was speaking and saying, "Lord," he prayed to the Father, the divinity. He said, "Lord, if you could, let it be that this cup passes from me. Let it be that I avoid what is facing me right now." But then he had to change perspective and look at it from the Spirit and say, "Nevertheless, nevertheless, it's not my will. It's not with the will of the flesh, but it's the will of the Spirit. It's the will of the Father. So nevertheless, I will do. It's not my will." And we can't go into consistency. We can't be consistent by following our own will. We have to be consistent in the will of the Father. When we are consistent in the will of the Father, there's a further verse that says, "But the anointing which ye have received of him abideth in you, and ye need not that any man teach you." And I love that. When we are anointed, and when we follow the anointing of the Lord, the anointing is the Holy Spirit of God that gives us ability beyond our own human capabilities. It gives us ability that we can do the things that Jesus did. It gives us the ability of God. He plants his anointing in us so that we can even overcome our own frailties, our own weaknesses, and perform the things of God. Amen. One thing that I absolutely love when I read in the Bible was that Stephen, the scripture says Stephen was full of the Holy Ghost. Think about this. Stephen was full of the Holy Ghost even unto his death. While he was being killed, he was still full up of the Holy Ghost. That while they were taking his life, he was saying, Lord, don't lay the blame on them. Don't lay this sin to their charge. Stephen was already forgiving them, and they were taking his life because of the anointing of the Holy Ghost that was allowing him to overcome, even in death. I faced a situation 2 months ago where I thought that, to be honest, I very quickly asked the question of myself, is this it? But very quickly, the answer came back to me that no, this is not it. You know, I said to myself, I have things to do. I'm not going anywhere. You could have heard the news that David Copeland has passed on just 2 months ago. You could have heard the news that David Copeland is no more. And he's moved on and he's transitioned. But no, the Lord had it not to be so. What could have become a great chaos in my life, God turned it around in minutes and shut it down so that it became, a situation, but I could look at it from the point of view of being an overcomer. And I was going into hospital and we were in the COVID situation, and I said to myself, Lord, you're going to cover me. I'm going into a hospital in a situation where people are not coming out alive. And I said, Lord, I'm looking to you for cover. I'm looking to you, Lord, for protection amongst the situation that is all around us, amongst the chaos that is all around us. I was able to hold on to the faith that the Lord has put in my life and hold on to the calling that he has called me with, and to say, Lord, I trust you. You can't hold on to something that's chaotic. You've got to find something that's consistent. And I'm looking right now and speaking to all of you who are watching. The world is looking for consistency in the chaos. The world is looking for people who are going to hold on and not let go to the situation. Not let go and let themselves be rushed along by the chaos and the situation that is in front of us. One last word. Paul said, be ye steadfast and unmovable, always abounding in the word, in the work of the Lord, knowing that it is he who has called you. We bless the name of the Lord today. And I pray that this word has enabled you to believe even stronger, to hold on a little tighter, even amongst the chaos. And you can be a witness to the consistency of God. And you can be a witness to the Lord of all that will never leave you. He's never going to run and leave you because of chaos. He will be in the very center of the storm. And it will be calm and peaceful. And you can continue to believe on the Lord. And when you come out the other side, you can glorify his name. You can magnify the name of the Lord and praise him for all the great things he has done for you. May the Lord bless you today in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Elder David Copeland, for your message. Consistency in chaos. My God, that is how we have to stand. That is how we have to be proactive, how we have to respond to the situations that we are facing right now. You know, things can appear chaotic in a time of crisis, but God will bring order in the times of chaos. And remember that our weapons that we have, they are spiritual weapons, and they are for pulling down of strongholds, and they are mighty by the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. We give God thanks. Amen. And just remember, how we respond, it's not by how the world views it. The world responds according to the systems of this world, but they are developed and they derive by the from the natural resources, from the natural outlook of how they see things. But our job is to respond in the Spirit. We fight in the Spirit. Our weapons are from the Spirit. So remember that because we're responding from the Spirit, God is fully charged in us. Jesus is with us, and we operate in the supernatural. So we will win and we will be successful if we remember to stand using our spiritual weapons. Glory to God. I give you thanks and praise. Father God, I pray the word that had gone forth, Lord, let it be a blessing. Let everybody's soul and spirit be ignited, Father God. Ignited to stand, ignited with conviction, knowing that you, oh God, are still strong. You, oh God, are in control. You, oh God, are intervening. And I pray for those souls, Lord God, who don't know you yet. I pray that you will stir up their spirit to want to call upon your name. And I pray that your spirit will fill them, comfort them, strengthen them, Lord God. And I pray that you will give them testimonies, Father God. Testimonies of how you've turned up in their lives, and that how they've received and believed you. Lord, we give you thanks and praise, Lord Jesus. And I pray, Lord God, that more souls will come to you through this word, through the blessings of this broadcast. We thank you. Thank you so much. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I give God thanks because I know that how I'm standing today, the things that I've experienced, just like a lot of you, some of them have been so negative, losing people, you know, people are ill, and, you know, people are being made redundant, some people are struggling, but I tell you something, God is with us, and he will help us. So Lord, we give you thanks. Thank you for tuning in. Please tune in again next week. If you want to get in contact, please stay for the credits at the end. You will see contact details. Please give and support the ministries that we continue with the broadcast and all the different ministries that we do. But I would like to close with the praise team singing a song. And I pray that you will be blessed by the song in your mighty name.
Okay, the Bible says without faith it's impossible to please God. And today our desire is to please Him. So get up and worship with us as we sing this song in Jesus' name.
My desire is to please you.
That's right.
To be more and more like you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Each and every day I lift my hands.
Like you,
more and more like you, Jesus.
Each and every hold you like the Lord.
I give you my heart.
Because I know. What I need you to
take
do
control,
or I'll never make it.
Take control. Take control. Take control.
Take control.
Take control.
And I'll be to love the Lord with all our mind, all our heart, and all of our souls. That's what we call totally committed.
We would like to take this opportunity to invite you to sow a seed in the ministry here at Bethel Lighthouse. The Bible tells us that our reward for giving comes from God. And we welcome your gift to support our many ministries. You can give by following the details on the screen or by clicking the giving link in the description box. God bless you.